F123 not launching, crashing, showing the ego dumper crash, or showing a black screen? Here are 16 ways you can fix it. Before we move forward, do us a favor by subscribing to our channel and liking this video. It's free and helps us a lot. You can also support us through Buy Me a Coffee. We do tons of research to find the working solutions for you. Your little support will help us continue making solution videos for you and others. Now, let's get started. Method 1. First, you need to make sure that your PC specifications meet the minimum requirement of the game. If they don't, then whatever you may try, the game won't run on your PC. Visit the game page on Steam or Epic Games and take a look at the specifications. If your PC meets the minimum requirements, then perform the following methods to get the best performance possible. Method 2. The next thing you can do is check the integrity of game files. Open Steam and head to Library. Right-click on F123 and select Properties. Click on Install Files tab and select the Verify Integrity of Game Files option. Wait for Steam to finish verifying and once done, play the game. Method 3. The next thing you can do is delete the config file to reset the settings. Open this PC, click on Documents from the Quick Access menu. Select the My Games folder. Next, open the F123 folder. Open the Hardware Settings folder. Here the hardware_settings_config is the config file. Right-click on both the files here and select Delete. Now run the game. Method 4. The next thing you can do is close any unnecessary program running in the background. Right-click on the task bar and select Task Manager. In the Processes tab, check for any unnecessary processes. Right-click on them and select End Task to close them. Apps like Discord, GeForce Experience, Google Chrome, and Nvidia ShadowPlay are some that you should close before playing games. Method 5. Another thing you can do is set the game to high performance from settings. Press the Windows plus I keys to open settings. Click on System and then select Display. Scroll down and click on Graphics Settings. Click on the Browse option and head to the F123 installation folder. Select the F123 EXE and add it. You will now see it here. Click on Options and select High Performance. Select Save to save the changes. If you don't know where the F1 installation folder is, then open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on F123 and select the Manage option. Click on Browse Local Files and this will open the installation folder. Remember the address and use it to browse in the graphics settings. If you have installed it from the EA app, simply right-click on the desktop shortcut and click on Open File Location. Method 6. The next thing you can do is change the power settings to high performance. Type control panel in the search bar and select the top result. Set view by to large icons. Click on power options. Expand show additional plans. Select high performance and run the game. Method 7. The next thing you can try is adding the game to the antivirus exclusion list on your PC. If you have any third-party antivirus, then add the game to the whitelist or exclusion list. Those who are using Windows Defender, here is how you can do it. Type Windows Security in the search bar and select the top result. Set Virus and Threat Protection. Scroll down and click on Manage Ransomware Protection. Next, click on Allow an App through Controlled Folder Access and select Yes. Click on Add an Allowed App option. Select Browse All Apps. Browse to the F123 installation folder and select the exe file. If adding the exe file doesn't fix the issue, then try disabling control folder access toggle and see if that solves the issue. Method 8. Another thing you can do is install the Visual C++ redistributables. What you need to do is search Visual C++ redistributables in Google. Click on the first link of Microsoft.com. We have also provided this link in the description, so you don't have to search. Download the Visual C++ redistributables for 2022. Remember to download the correct architecture, like downloading x64 for 64-bit systems and x86 for 32-bit systems. Install the downloaded file as shown. Now restart your PC. After the PC restarts, run the game and the error should be fixed. Method 9. Another thing you can do is update your Windows version. Type check for updates in the search bar and select the top result. Click on check for updates and wait for Windows to find the available updates. Download and install the available updates. Restart your PC. Method 10. The next thing you can try is updating the graphics drivers. If you're using an Nvidia graphics card, you can use GeForce Experience to update the graphics drivers. If you don't have it installed, download and install it from Nvidia's website first. Run GeForce Experience. After you open the app, click on drivers and check if any new drivers are available. Download and install it. For AMD graphics cards, the process is similar but uses the Radeon software instead of GeForce Experience. Run the app and check for any available drivers. Download and install the latest drivers. Restart your PC. Method 11. If updating the graphics driver doesn't work, try reinstalling them. Right-click on the Start menu and select Device Manager. Expand Display Adapters and right-click on the graphics driver. Select Uninstall Device and follow as shown. After the driver gets uninstalled, you will have to install it. For AMD graphics driver, install the Radeon app and run it. Similarly, for Nvidia graphics drivers, you will need to install the GeForce Experience. If you already have them installed, simply running them will automatically detect that the graphics drivers are missing and they will download and install them. Restart your PC after the drivers are installed. Then run the app again to check for any updates. If any update is available, download and install them. Method 12. The next thing you can do is install the latest version of DirectX. What you need to do is search DirectX runtime download on Google and open the first result from Microsoft.com. Here, select the installer language you prefer and click on download. Wait for the download to finish and run the installer. Complete the installation and wait for the installation to finish. After the installation completes, restart your PC. Now run the game. Method 13. The next thing you can try is running F123 as administrator. Open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on F123 and select the Manage option. Click on the Browse Local Files option, which will open the F123's installation folder. Locate the F123 exe file and right-click on it. Select the Properties option. Click on the Compatibility tab and check the Run this program as an administrator box. Click on Apply and OK to save the changes. Method 14. Another thing you can try is disabling all the in-game overlay. First, open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on F123 and select the Properties option. Uncheck the Steam In-Game Overlay option. Method 15. If you're using Logitech G Hub, then try restarting it and then restarting the game. You can also try closing the G Hub before running the game. Method 16. The next thing you can try is reinstall the game. Press the Windows plus R keys to open Run. Type appwiz.cpl and press Enter. Right-click on F123 and select Uninstall. Follow the on-screen instructions to complete the process and restart your PC. Reinstall the game and see if that solves the issue. So that's it. Subscribe to our channel and get quick solutions to all your tech issues. Join our Facebook group where you will get direct help on everything tech. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Support our dedicated team of troubleshooters and editors directly through Buy Me a Coffee. Thanks for watching, and always remember that we are here to help you out.